Hi there. Do you need to get organized for Christmas at this late date? If that's you, I am here to help. Today and for the 3 days following, I am going to be giving you an organized Christmas boot camp. But don't worry, you're not going to be exhausted and like sick because you're working so hard, I promise. Instead, each day, I am going to give you an idea and an action step that will get you organized and ready for Christmas and give you the peace of mind that I know you crave. So, my name is Melanie Wilson. I am a Christian psychologist turned homeschooling mother of six. I have been in such a disorganized place in my life that I was completely discouraged and feeling hopeless before I homeschooled. And then once I began homeschooling, I didn't think that I could do it. And I have learned some simple strategies that have helped me to feel on top of the to-dos in my life. And not just my to-dos, but have given me a way of making my relationships a priority as well. So, are you ready to get started? Let me know by commenting that you are here and tell me, as I've asked you on this page before, how organized you feel for Christmas on a scale of 1 to 10, with 10 being as organized as you could possibly feel. Okay. I've had people say, I'm a minus 15. So, if that's you, that's okay. That's okay. That's a fine starting point because we are going to think differently about organization today. And we're also going to take action because I know that that's what you want to do. You know, we can talk about it all day long, but if we don't do anything, nothing will change, right? Okay. So let me know that you're here and that you're listening and where you see yourself on the organization scale, ready for Christmas. Hey, Reagan, you feel about a 4. Okay. That's an okay place to start. All right, so here is our big idea for today, and it is this. And before you just dismiss it, listen to what I mean. Hey, Claudina, good morning. Okay, so the big idea is this: trust God. Trusting God will get us organized for Christmas. Now, you might be thinking, really, how? Especially if you feel like I so often have. That you are the one who have made a mess of things. Okay. You have overcommitted. You have been lazy and you haven't been doing things and you've let things pile up. You haven't been asking your kids to do what you know that they need to do. So why would God help you? And I want to tell you that God will. He loves you so much. He loves you so much that he cares about the mess that you're in. He cares about the little things. He cares that you don't have any Christmas gifts bought or any wrapped or any decorations done or any baking done or whatever it is that is most important to you. We're going to talk about that tomorrow. But he cares about you and he will help you. So I want to take you through an acronym that I have been using this year with great results, and that is the TRUST acronym. Okay, so the T in trust is for truth. We have to meditate on the truth because we are constantly telling ourselves lies. We're saying, I'm such a mess. I'm hopeless. There's no way I'll ever get organized in time for Christmas. Okay, and what do those kinds of statements that we tell ourselves, what does that do to our mood, right? It makes us depressed and less likely to take action, not more. So we want to meditate on God's truth. And I have chosen a passage for us to really and truly consider this morning from Luke chapter 10. If you want to look it up, it's Luke chapter 10, verses 38 to 42. It's a familiar story. You've heard it probably dozens and dozens of times, but it's so applicable to getting organized for Christmas. So here we are. As Jesus and his disciples were on their way, he came to a village where a woman named Martha opened her home to him. She had a sister called Mary who sat at the Lord's feet listening to what he said. But Martha was distracted, distracted by all the preparations that had to be made. Does that sound like anyone you know? Distracted by all the preparations that had to be made. Yep, I'm guilty. Give me a hands up or say me if you can relate to that. Being distracted by all the preparations that have to be made for Christmas. Okay, so let's continue on with this passage. She came to him, that's Martha. She came to him and asked, Lord, don't you care that my sister has left me to do the work by myself? Tell her to help me. Okay, now tell me if you can relate to feeling like you have to do everything. It's all up to you. You're like, wow, my kids and my husband are watching Christmas movies or football, and I'm just running around like a chicken with my head cut off, trying to do everything myself. And it's so frustrating. Okay, so Reagan and Claudine are saying, yep, they can relate. So do you feel like that as you're trying to get ready for Christmas? It's like, why is it all on me? I shouldn't have to be doing all of this, okay? And so Martha very boldly goes to the Lord and says, you need to tell her to help me. I do. I love this passage too. Okay, so I love how Jesus responds. And we're going to talk just a little bit about how I interpret it. I'm not a biblical scholar, but I see it a little differently than some other authors have said they see it. Okay, so Martha, Martha, the Lord answered, you are worried and upset about many things, about many things. Can we relate to that? I can relate to that. I have been worried about many things. I have been thinking about all the many things that I need to do. But here is how Jesus responds. But few things are needed. Few things are needed, or indeed, only one thing. Are you kidding me? One thing? And that is going to be our action step for today. I'll get more into that in just a bit. But yes, one thing, indeed, only one thing. Yeah, Martha and I would be friends. I know. I think most of us would be. Well, Jesus goes on to say, Mary has chosen what is better and it will not be taken away from her. And this is where some writers have said that, you know, our sole focus, our only focus should be on sitting at the Lord's feet. So we don't have Jesus in the body, in the flesh with us today. So we would interpret that today as meaning that I need to be spending all of my time in the Word and in prayer. And that is a wonderful, wonderful thing. And we're going to get into that. But it is not what Jesus called his disciples to do at all times. He often gave his disciples assignments. We can't be any different. Of course, we have to take care of our families. We have things to do. Meals do have to be made, right? So I don't think that that is what Jesus was saying. I think, first of all, he was chastising Martha for being worried and upset about many things. That's not our attitude. That is not what we're called to do. And yes, few things are needed. Few things are needed. And it's really true. If we think about all the things that are on our Christmas to-do list, really only a few of those are needed. Isn't that true? Only a few are needed. And in fact, at any given time, how many of those things can we really do with focus? Just one. Only one thing is needed. And this is really revolutionary. And so when I tell you what your action step is for today, that's what it's going to be, to do the one thing. But I'm going to hold off on that because I want to quickly go through the rest of the TRUST acronym with you. So the R in TRUST. So T is for truth. And I just gave you God's word, which is truth. And I encourage you to spend time in the word, even during this very busy Christmas season, because it will completely change your perspective on your busyness and getting ready for Christmas. The R in trust is for remember. I have been feeling stressed out and worried about many, many things. Honestly, I have been. And as I was lying in bed, getting ready to fall asleep, I was thinking about all of those things and I was feeling anxious, like there is no way I can get all of these things done. And this is what I did. I remembered how many times I have been lying in that same bed thinking that very same thought. And do you know that I could not come up with one instance where I had so many things to do and I didn't get them done and something catastrophic happened? I could not come up with one example. But instead, when I remember God's faithfulness to me, I remember an incident when I was a young mom, and with my personality, I had overcommitted to the point of it being ridiculous. And I was freaking out. And I was really early on in my faith walk with the Lord of believing that He cared about those small things in my life. And so I prayed and I asked Him to help me with this mess that I had made of my life. Do you know that one by one, my commitments dropped off and I didn't have them anymore? And my day was completely and totally manageable, only because God intervened on my behalf, had mercy on me. So I want you to remember, how many other times have you felt like, I'm unprepared, I'm not ready? And God was faithful to get you through. Okay, the you in trust is for understanding. You really don't need me to teach you how to pare down a to-do list. We're going to do it anyway. But you really don't need a complete education on how to get things done. You already know that your perfectionism is a problem, right? That your martyr self, that your do-it-all-yourself attitude is a problem. You know that you can do some simple things that you've already learned from the wisdom that God has already given you to take action to make a difference with your to-do list before Christmas. So I encourage you to listen to that wisdom, understand what God's wisdom is for you, and to act upon it. Okay, the S in trust is for supplication, which is prayer. This is where I am asking you to pray to God. Show me, Lord, what's most important. Show me what I can do to delegate. Show me some things that I can get rid of. Show me some ways that I can make this faster and easier. Show me some ways, how about this? Show me some ways that I can have an even more meaningful Christmas than I was planning on with my plans. And I believe that the Lord will do that. Why wouldn't He do that? Why wouldn't He answer that prayer? So I want you to pray specifically. Yes. Oh, isn't that great, Penny? Welcome, by the way. Okay, so the T in trust is for Thanksgiving. I got an email from Terry Maxwell, who this is a veteran, longtime homeschooling mother of many, who has played a pivotal role, honestly, in my faith life. And I loved her newsletter so much. She basically said this, that when you are overwhelmed, you know, getting ready for Christmas or whatever is going on that you're overwhelmed by, stop and thank God for the circumstances. Thank Him. So here's what she meant. So if you have all kinds of baking to do and you have to get it done, maybe that's because I used to bake, make cookies for our church cookie sale, or you have so many family members to purchase gifts for, or whatever it is, thank God that you belong to a church family, a loving, supportive church family, that you live in a country that you have the freedom to worship and celebrate Christmas. Thank God for that. Thank God that you have a big family to celebrate with. Thank God that you have children at home. Thank God that you are married. You know, you understand what I'm saying? I know you do. We can thank God in the circumstances. And Terry was saying that Thanksgiving just takes the overwhelm and the stress away when we are thankful. So be thankful. There is so much to be thankful for. So that's what I mean by trusting God. And that's our big idea for today. Trust God to get you organized for Christmas. Okay, so now I promised you an action step. I've already hinted at this before. But what I want you to do when you stop watching this video is to do the next thing. Jesus says there's just one thing that's needed. Just one thing, okay? And God's going to show you what that is. You know, if you stop thinking about the many things, all the things that you have to do, and you just ask God, what's the next thing? What's the next thing? He will show it to you. So I want to read this anonymous poem to you that I absolutely love. And I will put a link to it in the comments for this video, because you can print it out and just have it in front of you during this busy Christmas season. Do the next thing. From an old English parsonage down by the sea, there came in the twilight a message to me. Its quaint Saxon legend, deeply engraven, hath, it seems to me, teaching from heaven. And on through the doors the quiet words ring like a low inspiration. Do the next thing. Many a questioning, many a fear, many a doubt hath its quieting here. Moment by moment, let down from heaven, time, opportunity, and guidance are given. Fear not tomorrow, child of the King. Trust them with Jesus. Do the next thing. Do it immediately. Do it with prayer. Do it reliantly, casting all care. Do it with reverence, tracing his hand, who placed it before thee with earnest command. Stayed on omnipotence, safe neath his wing. Leave all resultings. Do the next thing. Looking for Jesus, ever serener, working or suffering, be thy demeanor. In his dear presence, the rest of his calm, the light of his countenance, be thy psalm. Strong in his faithfulness, praise and sing. Then, as he beckons thee, do the next thing. That's what I want you to do today. And I would love to hear what you think it is. Comment and tell me, what is the next thing that you feel the Lord is calling you to do? And then go and do it. One last thing I just wanted to mention to you today is, today I opened up the doors to Organize Homeschool Live. This is an online boot camp in January for Christian homeschooling families. It comes with a number of amazing bonuses, and it's unlike any other organizing course or book or product you've ever encountered, because we are going to be doing live action steps with our kids. I would love to have you join us. The link to find out more is in the description for this video. Thanks so much for joining me. I will be right back here at 10 o'clock Central Time, so 11 Eastern, tomorrow morning. See you then. Bye-bye.